A very good morning to one and all present here. I, Prachi Rastogi, Innovation Coordinator, Tirthankar Mahavir University, extend my warm welcome to Dr. Manjula Jain, President, Institution Innovation Council, TMU, Dr. Gitanshu, Convener, TMU IIC. It is my proud privilege to introduce our speaker for today's session on how to plan for a startup and legal and ethical steps, Dr. Vipin Jain, Director Principal of the Tirthankar Mahavir Institute of Management and Technology and Department of Hospital Administration. Principal of College of Law and Legal Studies and Chairperson of Center for JAN Studies. Formerly, he was Head of the Department, Department of Economics, Banking and Finance, College of Business, Hospitality and Tourism Studies, Fizi National University, Fizi, Iceland. Formerly, he was Head of the Department, Maharshi Arvind Institute of Science and Management, Jaipur. He is having 20 years of experience in teaching, research, consultancy, and administration. 5 research scholars have been awarded PhD under him and currently guiding 8 research scholars. Till date, he has guided 261 dissertations of MBA students, 423 market survey reports of BBA and MBA students, and around 216 projects of MBA and BBA students. He has completed 2 research projects and given 10 consultancies. He has been an examiner for PhD. He published 44 research papers, 12 Indian patents, 12 Australian patents, 5 books, and several chapters in different books, written course materials for Rajshri Tandon Open University, and reviewed 3 books. He is a member of editorial board in 4 journals and referee of 10 journals. His Google Scholar details is as follows: H index 7, I index 6, and citations 364. I welcome you, sir. It's a proud moment for us to have you with us. Please proceed, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. I'm audible to all of you.
Yes.
I'm audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Very good afternoon now. It's between morning and afternoon, 12 noon. So very good noon to you all. We are going to study how to plan startups. Before that, Government of India has initiated various programs for budding managers and business managers or entrepreneurs to start their own business venture. Why it is so? Because starting a business venture is not a cup of tea of everyone, but India government wants that each and every student who is studying right now MBA should start their own business and they become job provider rather than job searchers. This is the main objective of the government, but it is very difficult to start a business. Why it is very difficult? Because starting a business is very easy thing, but managing and operating into in a profit is a very difficult task. So what are the important steps that are required to start a business, which I am right now in this particular presentation, I want to share what are the different steps required to start a business. As you see in your screen, there are 10 important steps to start your business, like refine your idea, write a business plan, access your finances, determine your legal business structure, registered with the government, purchase an insurance policy, build your team, choose your vendors, brand yourself and advertise, and grow your business. So these are the 10 important steps that I will be discussing today with you all. Like the first important, when we start a business, what important thing that we require That is very important. Whenever you are a management student or a business student, scan the environment nearby your area, in your country, in your local city, and ask why this is happening. Add why in any of the situation. Like what Simon Sinek says, always start with why. And Glenn Kutek, CEO of Awake Consulting and Coaching, told to Business News Delhi, it is good to know why you are launching your business. In this process, it may be wise to differentiate between whether the business serves a personal why or a marketplace why. These are the two important things: personal why and marketplace why. What is personal why? Personal why? Why you want to start a business? Because of your own personal needs or the needs of marketplace. But my point, I want to start a business because I need money to feed my family. It's a personal. While you are starting a business for a marketplace, why? That the society is needing this particular product and I want to deal in this particular product. That is the answer, marketplace why. So when your why is focused on meeting a need in the marketplace, the scope of your business will always be larger than that it is designed to serve a personal needs. So very important goal, that is, whenever you are starting your business, define your why. Is it personal or marketplace? So my point of view from this presentation is, you try to explore your market and try to find out what exactly the need of the society. Like last year, during this month, we had a lockdown and immediately a lot of new business idea came into existence and a lot of new companies started their new product and services. Like what I am seeing in 1 year, many companies are approaching to the universities and institutions about the online platform of the lecture delivering. Before that, frankly speaking, I never experienced giving lectures through Zoom and taking lectures from Zoom. So this is the situation where society needs that. There is a social distancing, Corona is affecting day-to-day life, and even students cannot move to the college for their education. So immediately a lot of things came into the market and they are now creating a very good business proposition. So find out what exactly market needs, what exactly society needs. I request all the students, please mute your mic so that I can deliver my lecture in a proper manner. Lot of noises are coming from your background. I request Pachi ma'am to identify the student and please inform him to mute his mic. So, dear students, the important thing, add why. When you are adding why in any of the existing product or services, you can create a new idea of delivering that services into a proper manner. Then there are different ways or to start your own business, like considering franchising. Franchise is another option too, because it is launched by an established company. They know their business model and they know their client. Only you require fund and a good location, because everything is supported by the franchisee business. So if you are in your particular area, if you think that this is not right now, these product or services are not given by any of the business proposition, then you can start off going into a franchisee business, and various websites are available from where you can get the idea of starting a franchisee business. Then the next step is brainstorm your business name. Business name is a very catchy and it is very important that whenever you start a business name carries a very important weightage. Regardless of which option you can choose, it's vital to understand the reasoning behind your idea. Stephanie, owner of business by design and former director of operation and women business program to a cohesion center, warned the entrepreneurs against writing a business plan or brainstorming a business before nailing down the business idea. So if you had cleared and your idea is there and you want to start any business, then definitely business name is a very important thing that you have to take care of it. Then clarifying your target customers. I can tell you various international brands, they are deals in full sleeve shirts. But when they entered into Indian market, they'd started half sleeve shirt in Indian market, especially in North Indian conditions. Why? Because you have to know your customers what exactly they want. In 12 months, only 3 months are for winter and rest are for summers. And the summers are very, very, even 40, 45 degree temperature is going in the summers. So the shirt owner had decided to launch as per the target customers. Same way, I can give you an example of McDonald's. McDonald's deals in beef and non-vegetarian items. They are known for non-vegetarian items. But in India, they had launched McAloo Tikki, McAloo, that is the brand that is available only in Indian conditions. So these are the different examples where international, multinational companies are even going for target customers. So before starting any business, you should know what exactly your target customers are, to whom you want to do your business. Like, If you see the cartoon channels these days, you will find that these ads are coming to attract the 10-year, 12-year-old child so that they can pursue their parents and they can go for these products. So same way, whenever there is women's serial is coming on TV, then you will find different ads regarding women's. So whenever the cricket is coming, the different advertisements are coming. So they know which type of target customers are seeing that particular episode or TV serial. And they just go for that particular ad. So same way, whenever you start any business, you should know your target customers. Once you have idea in place, need to ask yourself a few important questions. What is the purpose of business? Who are you selling to? What your goal and goals are? How will you finance your startup cost? These questions can be answered by a business plan. So now the next is the second important point is write a proper business plan. A lot of mistakes are made by new business rushing into the things without pondering these aspects of business. You need to find your target customer base, who is going to buy your product and service. If you cannot find evidence that a demand for your idea, then what should be the point? So important and second step is write a proper business plan. Whenever you get an idea, you know about your customers, you know about your product, then write on a piece of paper a business plan. Before writing a business plan, conduct market survey. What is market research or market survey? Market survey is who is your target customer, focus on that, conducting through market research on your field or demographic or potential client is an important part of crafting a business plan. This involves survey holding focus group, researching CEOs and public data. Market research help you to understand target customers, their needs, preferences, and behaviors, as well as your industry and competitors also. Many small business professionals recommends gathering demographic information and conducting a competitive analysis to better understand the opportunities and limitations within your market. And we called it as a SWOT analysis: strength, weakness, opportunity, and threat. The best small business have product or service that are differentiated from the competition, and these have significant impact on your competitive landscape and allow you to convey unique value to potential customers. So this is the important why we want to conduct market survey, to answer these questions, to find out these particular things so that we can write a proper business plan. Then consider an exit strategy also. It is also good an idea to find out or construct an exit strategy as you compile your business, generating some idea of how you will eventually exit the business forces you to look to the future. Too often new entrepreneurs are so excited about their businesses and so sure everyone everywhere where will be a customer that they give very little, if any, time to show plan on leaving the business, said by Josh Tolley, CEO of both Shift Capital and Kavana. When you board an aeroplane, what is the first thing they show you? How to get off it when you go to a movie? When do they point out before feature begins to play where the exits are? Your first week of kindergarten, they line up all the kids and teach them fire drills to exit the building. Too many times I have witnessed the businesses leaders, they do not have 3 or 4 predetermined exit routes. So important thing, whenever you are writing a business plan, also think about exit strategy, that if your business do not go well, then how you will come out from that business and think of your future to go ahead in your life. Because running a lost business or a venture is not advisable by any of the business leaders. Then the third important point is, after the business plan, assess your finance. Finance is like a blood in your body. Like body, treat body as an organization. Same, body works with your heart. Heart, get out the vestige and circulate a new pure oxygenated blood to your body cells so that your body get energy and whatever waste come out, the blood takes away, and then different system of our body take out whatever the waste from our body and give whatever the body needs with the help of blood. Same way, finance is important. It's just like a blood. If your flow of finance is proper, your business is healthy. When your finance is not proper, then definitely your business is not healthy. So find out and try to find the strategies which make your finances proper, in proper flow. High finances also, low finance also, same way. If high BP is there, your body is not healthy. Low BP is there, your body is not healthy. So same way, proper accurate blood flow circulation is required. Same way, the proper circulation of finance is also required. Finance is just important aspect as blood in our body. So how you will get finance? How will you access your finance? Find out. Because many startup fails because they run out of money before turning a profit. It's never a bad idea to overestimate the amount of startup capital you need, as it can be a while before the business begins to bring a sustainable revenue. So before, whenever you are planning for any startup, just assess your finance in various points. Second important point while assessing your finances, find out your break-even analysis. What is break-even analysis? Whenever we go for starting any business, we require a situation where our business is not having neither loss nor a profit. And when this will be this situation will come, That exactly we want to know before starting our business. So this is the formula. Break-even point, break-even analysis is a very important aspect to start whenever you are going to start your business. Every entrepreneur should use these formulas as a tool because it informs you about the minimum performance your business must achieve to avoid losing money. Furthermore, it helps you to understand exactly where your profit comes from so you can set production goal accordingly. So find out break even points of your business and when it will come. And then you can identify that it will be coming in 3 years, 4 years, 1 year, 2 months. Then definitely you can take out from the situation what exactly money you need, finance you need. Watch your expenses. The important point, expenses. There are two types of expenses, fixed and variable. Find out fixed expenses and find out variable expenses. And then try to make out with your production and service production. What type of new equipment you want, why you want, when you want, then only you go to purchase it. A lot of startup tends to spend money on unnecessary things. Said by Gene Pelton, founder and CEO of Rare Form New Media. We worked with a startup that had 2 employees but spent a huge amount on office space that would fit for 20 people. They also leased a professional high-end printer that were more suited for a team of 100. It had key card to track who was printing what and when. Spend as little as possible when you start. And only the things that are essential for the business to grow, be a success. Luxurious can come when you are established. So important area, watch your expenses also. Consider your funding options. There are various funding options and even Startup India is one of the important initiative taken by central government. Go to the site, find out what are the different businesses the startup funds is giving by the central government. Startup capital of your business can come from various means. The best way to acquire funding from your business depends on several factors, including creditworthiness, the amount needed, and available options. So business, the first important thing is business loan. Different banks, commercial banks are giving loans at affordable rates, and also central government is also giving loans for startup to take initiative and get loan from these different initiative taken by the central government. Business grants are similar to loan, how they do not need to be paid back. Business grants are typically very competitive and come with this stipulation with business must meet to be considered, but it is very difficult to find out. Investors, startup requiring significant funding upfront may want to bring an investor. Investor can provide several million dollars or more to fledgling companies with the expectation that the vickers are. Or I can say angel investors are there. Angel broking companies are there, which are funding different business ideas. And there are various websites available for this. Choosing the right business bank, as Marcus Anwar also find, is bank is also very important profile. Choosing a right business bank is again an important aspect. As Anwar said, they are like big bank that look at your credit score and will more selective to loan money to small businesses. Not only that, but small bank want to build a personal relationship with you and ultimately help you out, help you if you run into problem and miss a payment. Another good thing about small bank is that decisions are made at the branch level, which can be much quicker than big bank. So choose a right bank that can help you out in any adverse situation. Fourth important point, determine your legal business structure. Various legal business structures are there. The first, if you are only want to start your own business, then it's a sole proprietorship. You are the whole soul owner of your business. Second is partner. When two or more persons are aligned together with a common motive to start a particular business venture and sharing a profit, then it's called a partnership. Corporation, you can start business with your corporation also. If you want to separate your personal liability from your company liability, you may want to consider forming on several types of corporation. Although each type of corporation is subject to different guidelines, this legal structure generally makes a business a separate entity for its owner, and therefore corporations can own property, assume liability, pay tax, enter contracts, sue and be sued like any other individual. So, as per Derek Jordan, managing attorney at Jordan Counsel, corporations, especially corporations, are suitable for new business that plan on going public or seeking fund from venture capitalists in near future. Then they can go launch a corporation and then they can go and start their business. Then we have different types of companies, private and public limited companies. This is also a common structure for small business to start and set. This is a hybrid structure, the legal protection on the corporation while allowing the tax and benefit of the partnership. Then registered with the government. Whenever you start your business, registered your business with the central government, state government and local government. Local government at your local area, Nagar Nigam, like you will need acquire a variety of business license before you can legally operate your business. Some of the business required legal licensing also. So for that, you must get these licenses, whatever type of, if it is required NOC from state government, acquire that. If it is required NOC from central government, acquire that. If it is required NOC from no objection certificate from local government, then arrange all these certificates and register with the government. Then we have different articles of association and memorandum of association. So to become an officially recognized business entity, you must register with the government. Corporation needs an article of incorporation document, which includes your business. Sole proprietor does not need anything, but registered and whatever application form is there, registered yourself. And in partnership, it is governed by Indian Partnership Act 1932. So the partnership deed is required for that, where the common intention of all the partners are written in a piece of paper. Similarly, for a limited liability companies, we have article of association and memorandum of association that is required as per the Companies Act. Then employer identification number, with the tax authorities, because whenever you start your business, you have to pay tax to the government, and for that you require a separate number, and that is called as employer identification number. Then income tax forms, what type of income tax form you have to fill. Indian government for startup, they are basically reducing the taxes for next 4 or 5 years, depending on the whatever type of business you are going to start. Then sixth is purchase and insurance policy also. Because uncertainty is there, you are taking a risk. So for minimizing a risk, you require a proper insurance policy so that it safeguards your business and your interest in your business. Then build your team. It is very important. Without team, you cannot run successful business. A single person cannot do. So required a proper team as what team is a very important, because you have an idea, you have finance, you have money to purchase equipment, but you required human resource to manage all these things. Unless you are planning to be your only employee, you are going to need to recruit or hire a great team like Jaworski, CEO and founder of MediaMath, said entrepreneur needs to give people element their businesses the same attention they give their product. Your product is built by persons only. He says, identify your founding team, understand what gap exists, and determine how and when you will address them, and should be top priority figuring out how the team will work together. Is equally important defining roles and responsibility, division of labor, how to give feedback, how to work together when not everyone is in the same room will save you a lot of headaches down the lane. And the important principle of creating a good team is whatever the personal problem, whatever the personal goals of our employee should be converted into organizational goal. Iske liye, I will give you one small story from Dhirubhai Ambani. In 2002, the earthquake came in Bhuj area of Gujarat, and nearby the refinery of Reliance is also working out there, operating there. 90% of the refinery was not able to operate due to this earthquake. Various engineers from foreign and different countries came to find out the solution that how early this particular refinery can become an operating refinery. For that, Dhirubhai Ambani told all the engineers that whatever money you will save, I will provide 50% of that particular money to you all if you do as early as possible make this refinery as a operating as early as possible. Imagine, first they told that this particular refinery will require 6 months, and when the statement given by Dhirubhai Ambani, all the team started working 24/7, and that machinery came out at 90% operating in just 2 months, saving 4 months operating expenses. So this is the team. This is required by team managers, how to build a good team and convert their personal goals into the organizational goals. This is the important funda. And for startup, you require very good team so that they can save your money, they can sell your product, they can work 24/7 for you and your company. Choose your vendors, because without vendors, you cannot earn profit. So you require vendors to sell your products. So important is good team and good vendors. Both are coming from HR, human resource. So your team is HR, and to whom you are selling your product is also HR, and vendors are coming from this community. So important is choose right business partners so that they can promote your business, your product and services, and whatever problems are coming at the their end, they just tell to you so that you can find some strategy to find out the solutions. Ninth is, brand yourself and advertise. Before you start selling your product or service, you need to build up your brand and get a following of people ready to jump when you open your door of your business. So proper advertisement plan should be there at different medias. Various medias are available, advertising medias are available. You should know where to give your advertisement, where the targets, which part of target segment are using what type of media. You should know that and then float and brand your business. Branding your business is opening a friendly company website where all the informations are there. Social media, various social media platforms where you promote your business and your product or services, CRM, customer relation management, various softwares are coming right now. You buy a good software which gives all the information to your customers, and whatever important information you want to send, you can go through this CRM platform. And then a logo. Create a logo also, which is understandable, friendly, attractive, and which can be followed by different customers, because this creates a branding image in the market, like logo of Nike, logo of TM, logo of various companies, Woodland. You whenever the logo comes, you know, you recognize that particular brand. So create a friendly, attractive logo of your business. And then last step is grow your business. Your launch, first sale, begin your task as an entrepreneur to make a profit and stay afloat. You always need to be growing your business. It's going to take time and efforts, but you will get your business what you put into it. Collaborating with more established brands in your industry is a great way to achieve growth. Reach out to other companies and ask for some promotions in exchange for a free product sample or service. Partners with charity organization and volunteer some of your time or product to get your name out there. To grow your business quickly, check out the business growth tips. Various tips are available on internet, and these are the 10 important areas or steps to start your business in a legal way that I discussed today in my presentation, which is refine your idea, write a proper business plan, assess your finances, determine your legal business structure, then register with the government, follow all the requirement of your government, whether it's a central, state or a local government, purchase an insurance policy to safeguard your business, build a proper team, choose vendors that support your business idea, brand yourself and advertise and grow your business and maintain the pace of growing your business. And always try to find out new business areas so that you can develop and create a very good startup. Thank you very much for listening to me. And I think yes, please. Yes. I'm audible to you.
Have any questions?
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon. Akshay.
Yes, sir. Sir, I have a question, sir. Question is that, sir, ki agar maan lijiye hum apna koi business start karna cha rahe hain, sir. Aur market, jis market mein hum start karna cha rahe hain, wahan us market mein already us business ke competitor hain. But somewhere we know that our business idea is quite good than our competitor. So how to manage that situation, sir?
देखिए, मुझे लगता है आपका जो प्रश्न है वो ये है कि पहले से ही वहाँ competitors available है और आपका product या आपकी जो services है वो आपके competitor की competitive advantages के साथ आप start कर सकते हैं. तो my dear student, हमेशा बिजनेसेस करने का जो सही तरीका है वो कॉम्पिटिटर्स के साथ मिलके करना चाहता है. आपने देखा होगा मुरादाबाद में भी सबसे पहले टाटा का शोरूम खुला, उसके पास में हुंडई का शोरूम खुला और अभी लेटेस्ट वॉक्सवैगन का शोरूम खुला और मारुति का तो बहुत पहले से ही वहां था. तो एक मार्केट क्रिएट हुआ. ऐसे ही अगर आप मुरादाबाद रीजन को देखेंगे, हरथला में बहुत ज्यादा कार डेंटिंग की और कार रिपेयरिंग की शोरूम्स है, लेकिन वही मार्केट अब डेवलप हो रहा है नियर बाय पागबड़ा, जहां पर वो जो हाईवे जा रहा है वहां पर बहुत सारे आपको दिखेंगे, क्योंकि कार खरीदने वाले यही है और यहाँ रिपेयरिंग वाले आ रहे हैं, तो एक के बाद एक आते जा रहे हैं. तो हमेशा बिजनेस कॉम्पिटिटर्स अगर वहां है और आपके पास कॉम्पिटिटिव एडवांटेज है, तो मुझे नहीं लगता कि कहीं दिक्कत है, क्योंकि कस्टमर्स को पता है कि उस प्रोडक्ट और सर्विस के लिए उस एरिया में ही आपको जाना मिल सकता है। और ये कॉम्पिटिटर्स का हमेशा एक माइंडसेट भी होता है कि जहां सबसे ज्यादा दुकानें होती है वो उसी मार्केट में जाने, उस पर्टिकुलर प्रोडक्ट सर्विस के लिए उसी मार्केट में जाना चाहता है, क्योंकि वो ये जानता है कि अगर वो नहीं करेंगे तो कोई और कर लेगा। तो मेरा अक्षय यही कहना है, जो मेरा एक्सपीरियंस कहता है वो ये कहता है कि अगर आपके पास कॉम्पिटिटिव एडवांटेज है और आप वहां के जो कॉम्पिटिटर्स हैं उनकी कमियों को स्कैन कर चुके हो और आपका प्रोडक्ट उन कमियों को दूर कर सकता है।
थैंक यू सो मच सर। ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ तीर्थंकर महावीर यूनिवर्सिटी इंस्टीट्यूट इनोवेशन काउंसिल आई एक्सटेंड माय थैंक्स टू यू फॉर योर प्रेशियस टाइम एंड नॉलेज शेयरिंग। Our students feel enlightened with your words and learns a lot of about how to plan for a startup. Hope we'll conduct some more sessions with you and learn some other aspects of startups with you. Thank you so much, sir. Thanks.